This is part 3 of cloud computing tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss what are containers and how are they different from virtual machines. In our previous video, we discussed what are virtual machines and how they allow us to run multiple applications on a single physical server. However, with each virtual machine that we create, there is a lot of overhead, both in terms of cost and maintainability. Let's understand this with an example. Let's say we have four applications, app 1 to app 4. We want to be able to run all these four apps on one physical server, server 1. Obviously, we cannot run applications directly on the server hardware. We need an operating system like Windows or Linux. This is the host operating system, that is, the operating system at the server level. On top of this, we install a piece of software called Hypervisor. It is this hypervisor that creates and manages virtual machines. We have four apps that we want to run in isolation on this single physical server. So we create four virtual machines. As we discussed in our previous video, a virtual machine virtualizes the hardware of the physical server. This means each virtual machine that is created gets a slice of the server hardware. In our case, we created four virtual machines. So each VM gets 25% of memory, disk space, processor, and other server hardware resources. Now, our business applications, that is app 1 to app 4, cannot directly run on a virtual machine. Keep in mind, a virtual machine virtualizes the server hardware. This means, in simple terms, a virtual machine is a slice of the underlying server hardware, and an application cannot run directly on the hardware. So, for a virtual machine to be able to run a software application, it needs a full copy of its own operating system. In our case, we have four virtual machines. So, this means we need to install four operating systems, one on each virtual machine, usually Windows or Linux. This operating system that is installed on a virtual machine is usually called guest operating system. So on top of this guest operating system on the VM, we install our business application and any dependencies it might need. Now, just imagine the server resources that are required to install and run four operating systems. So much of server resources like disk space, memory, and processor time are wasted just to keep these VMs up and running. In addition to the wasted server resources, each installation of the operating system also needs admin time. For example, if there is an update or a security patch available for the operating system, the admin needs to download and install it on all the affected VMs. In addition to this, we also have to pay for four operating system licenses. Remember, a virtual machine is like a computer within a computer. It has its own operating system. So, for a virtual machine to be up and running, its operating system must also be booted up. Booting up an entire operating system obviously consumes a lot of time. In our example, if we want App 1 to be up and running, VM 1 operating system must be booted up in addition to booting up the host operating system, that is, the operating system at the physical server level. Now, let's understand what containers are and how they are set out to solve these issues. We have a side-by-side comparison here. Remember, a virtual machine virtualizes the server hardware, whereas containers virtualizes the operating system. That is, it's an abstraction at the operating system level. Multiple containers can run on the same machine, and more importantly, they can share the host operating system kernel. Unlike a virtual machine, a container does not require its own operating system. So straight away, you can say the amount of disk space, RAM, processor time, and other server resources that are saved. Each container packages your application code and its dependencies together. If you have three apps to run on a single physical server, you create three containers. Each application thinks it is running on a dedicated operating system and a dedicated server hardware, but in reality, all the container applications are sharing the same host operating system and hardware. In case of virtual machines, admin time is required to install security patches and keep up to date host operating system and the guest operating systems on all the VMs. In case of containers, no matter how many containers we have on our server, there is just one host operating system that demands admin time. From the cost standpoint, in case of VMs, we have to pay for host and the guest operating systems of all the VMs, whereas in case of containers, we have to pay just for one host operating system. A container is very small compared to a virtual machine. Since a container does not have its own operating system to boot up, it can usually be brought online in a very less time compared to booting up an entire virtual machine and its operating system. We'll see virtual machines and containers in action in our upcoming videos. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.